55 teams, only 24 spots up for grabs for next year's Euro 2020 competition. Which teams will make it and which teams won't? Guys, I'm your boy Dominic Rich and I'm back to talk about the Euro 2020 qualifiers. This is the second day. Yesterday we had 10 games and today we had 7 fixtures. Not a lot of big, you know, matchups, but still we had some very, very exciting games. So let's just dive into that right now. To do a quick recap of what happened so far in qualifiers, Kazakhstan defeated Scotland 3-0. We had Cyprus defeating San Marino 5-0. Well, that's not a surprise, right, guys? Northern Ireland defeating Estonia 2-0. Netherlands defeating Belarus 4-0. Memphis Depay to start off that. Slovakia defeating Hungary 2-0. Croatia defeating Azerbaijan 2-1 in a match they had to really, really fight for that win. Israel and Slovenia played to a 1-1 draw. Macedonia defeated Latvia 3-1. Austria lost to Poland 1-0. And Belgium spanked Russia 3-1. So Friday, March 22nd, 2019, we had 7 fixtures. Let's just run through these matches because yesterday I made a 25-minute video, but I don't want it to be 25 minutes today at all. So we had games from groups A. I lost my thing there. I had such a groove going there. And then I lost the thing. Okay, we had games from group A, B, and H. So only 3 groups featuring today. So let's start with the group A matches. When I'm done, I will do a recap of all the current group standings, you know, and so forth and so on and, you know, stuff like that. But we still have matches tomorrow to complete match day 1 of the qualifiers. So it's quite a lot of games to play, you know. A lot of teams, a lot of games to play. So let's start with the Bulgaria versus Montenegro fixture. That game ended 1-1. 1-1 draw. Remember, Bulgaria wasn't too bad in the UEFA Nations League. And Montenegro was kind of subpar, you know. They didn't get promoted or anything like that. So in this game, Mugosha scored in the 50th minute. And we had Nedelev scoring the equalizing penalty in the 82nd to give Bulgaria, you know, 1 point. So the points split. And I guess both teams will be happy with that. So let's not talk too much about this match. But Montenegro, you know, a team who has never qualified for the World Cup. The Euro history, I don't know too much about. But Montenegro is a new nation. Don't think they have ever qualified for the Euros. I might be wrong. But, you know, Bulgaria, you know, they were a very, very good team in the early 90s, guys. As you could recall from World Cup 1994. So, second game. I'm going to leave the best one for last. The second game, let's talk about the Group B match that I saw. Portugal 0, Ukraine 0. So disappointed that Portugal wasn't able to actually win this game. But then again, you have to give props to Ukraine for actually, you know, defending very, very well. The keeper pulled off some big saves, you know, to pick up a point. You know, let's not all forget about, you know, defensive displays. We all want to see goals. We all want to see, you know, players attacking. But when a team defends well, we have to commend them as well. And Andrei Shevchenko's Ukraine did just so. Cristiano Ronaldo had a few shot save. You know, Andre Silva, he had a shot save. A few more other big chances by Portugal squandered. Let's just say that. You know, Diego Sosa late in the match, he had a chance as well. But for Ukraine, they had a big, big chance through the just naturalized Brazilian Junior Moraes. That was a very, very good opportunity to pick up 3 points and crush the heart of the Portuguese. But, you know, he put it over the bar. But Ukraine, very, very good defensive display. Not so hot going forward. Portugal, let's just say they should have scored. They had a lot of opportunities and they weren't able to put it in the back of the net. So I don't have much more to say about that game, but Portugal, the defending champions, always look like, you know, they struggle to pick up results. Remember when they won the Euro back in 2016, they came to the group stages with, you know, I think it was 3 draws, and then, you know, they had a couple games going to extra time. The finals went to extra time and all. So Portugal, even if they get the job done, it's usually very, very scrappy, you know, despite having the world's best player, arguably Cristiano Ronaldo, in their team. So 1 point apiece for Portugal and Ukraine. Then we had Luxembourg defeating Lithuania 2-1 in Group B. I won't go too much into that fixture because these two teams are basically two minnows, but Luxembourg seems like a team who are improving by the day. Then in Group H, we had Moldova 1, France 4. Well, come on, guys. France versus Moldova. We expect France to blow them away any time. Griezmann scored in the 24th minute, Varane in the 27th, Giroud in the 36th, and Mbappe in the 87th. I think Griezmann actually, you know, chipped in for an assist in this game as well. Hence the reason he made it on the thumbnail. So, yes, guys, I made a thumbnail before I made a video. Put a lot of effort into this. So, Griezmann, let's say he's the man of the match, even though I did not watch the game. But from, you know, what you can tell from the, you know, involvement in the goals, definitely. So, France, big 3 points. Remember, France won the World Cup in 2018, and they were runners-up at Euro 16. So, they are looking to, you know, lift the Euros after winning the World Cup. You know, that seems to be a trend as well. So, as expected, France, you know, pulling off a big win. Moldova was able to peg a goal back to Ambrose in the 89th minute. You know, France should have kept a clean sheet, but then again, maybe they got complacent late in the game, especially after just scoring. You know, maybe they were looking for more, they were just having fun, and, you know, they conceded a goal. But still, it's a good win. You know, when you meet these little teams, you have to keep your foot on their necks and crush them. You know, can't be complacent or else they will upset you. Next Group H fixture, we have Andorra 0, Iceland 2. So Iceland, a team who has been struggling after the World Cup, you know, they have been putting on, you know, a few good results as of late. And this result was expected. You know, Andorra, a minnow in Europe, but I think they have been, they did put out a few good performances in the UEFA Nations League. And, you know, who knows what could have happened. But Iceland getting the job done here. Another Group H fixture, Albania 0, Turkey 2. So in Group H, as we can see, we have Moldova, France, Andorra, Iceland, Albania, and Turkey. This is a very, very easy group for France. They should win every single game, you know, in this group. Not underestimating the other teams, but France should win all their games. So Turkey starting off on the right foot. You know, Turkey always, you know, messes up in tournament football. They missed World Cup 2018. They barely made it to Euro 2016. I can remember when Selçuk İnan scored that beautiful free kick to book their place, you know, in the tournament. And then they, you know, they missed World Cup 2018. They didn't do well, you know, in the UEFA Nations League. But, you know, they're looking to turn their fortunes around with a big win to open, you know, qualifiers. Burak Yılmaz, man, the man up front, he's still doing his thing, scored in the 21st minute. And then Hakan Çalhanoğlu in the 55th minute. Well, Çalhanoğlu definitely needs to step up for Turkey. You know, he has been on a decline, in my opinion, since, you know, his days at Bayer Leverkusen, Hamburg, Bayer Leverkusen, you know. Not so great at AC Milan, but, you know, he still seems to have his touch. He was I don't know if he still is a freaking genius, but God damn, he used to put him in sweetly. But, you know, Albania hasn't been playing well as of late. Remember, they had a really good start in the UEFA Nations League, and then they just petered off and placed last in their group. I don't know if they got relegated, but You know, they did not do well in their last few matches at all. So I said I will leave the best game for last, and that game is England 5, Czech Republic nil. Remember, Czech Republic, they're not a pushover team. They did well in the UEFA Nations League, placing second in their group behind Ukraine and above Slovakia. So they didn't do too bad. They were a team in pretty decent form. But England, man, England, they are in red hot form. When you talk about red hot form, England placed fourth at the World Cup. They topped their UEFA Nations League group ahead of Croatia, who were in the finals of the World Cup, and Spain, one of the favorites to win the World Cup and the UEFA Nations League, but flopped. Guys, come on. England, one of the most informed teams right now under Gareth Southgate. He has rejuvenated this team, and you know, with his introduction of all these younger players, you know, that's why England are doing so well. You know, youth always prevails. Nah, they don't. But it's just a mixture of, you know, experienced players and young players who have been performing well at club level getting rewarded. If players are in form, reward them and they will pay dividends. And that's what's happening with England right now. 5-0, guys. Could you believe that? Smashed, completely smashed Czech Republic. A hat trick from Raheem Sterling, a man who has been criticized by the English media time after time after time, but he just, you know, speaks on the field and he scores a hat trick for his country. Remember, for Man City, he has been on fire for the past 2 seasons, improving in leaps and bounds, and bam, you know, for the national team, he's coming up trumps again. He has been in good form for the national team. I think he scored a few goals in Spain. He did score, I think. I can't quite recall. There's so much football being played. Can't recall everything, but you know, I think he was like going through a stalemate in the national team. He hadn't scored for a while, and then he, you know, basically he scored, and then now he comes up big with a freaking hat trick. This is big. This is huge. You know, shutting up the critics. I really like that. So we had Sterling scoring in the 24th, 62nd, and 68th minute. We have Harry Kane chipping in with a penalty in the 47th minute, you know, second minute of first half, extra time, and Kalas scoring an own goal in the 84th. Czech Republic failed to reply. So really good stuff by England. We also saw Callum Hudson-Odoi making his debut, a competitive debut for Callum Hudson-Odoi, and I think he is the youngest ever England player to make his debut in a competitive game, if I could, you know, recall. So congratulations to the young man. He has a bright future. You know, Jadon Sancho was involved. Declan Rice also made his English debut. Remember, he played for the Republic of Ireland before, so he is not new to international football, but he has switched his allegiance to England. So congratulations to the young man, man. Jadon Sancho, I think he pulled off one of these assists as well. You know, the England team is looking good, man. They're looking good. The lineup included Pickford, Walker, Chilwell, Dyer, who had to go off early injured. You know, Michael Keane, Maguire, Sancho, Henderson, Kane, Ali, Sterling. On the bench, we had Heaton, Butland, Trippier, Rose, Tarkowski, Rice, Ward-Prowse. I really like that they called up James Ward-Prowse. Plays for Southampton, really talented player. Ross Barkley, Callum Wilson, and Callum Hudson-Odoi. What a talented team, man. What a freaking talented team. So England starts off their qualifying campaign on a high. Remember, they play in the UEFA Nations League final. Well, the semi-final, but they call it the final, alongside, you know, Switzerland, Portugal, and what's the other team? The Netherlands, of course. How could I forget? But another exciting day, second day of Euro qualifiers, you know. Just had to, you know, pull out the camera and talk about them. Every day of qualifiers, I will be doing one of these recaps, you know. Just want to talk about the game, just keep, you know, up with all this football that have been playing. But this game was definitely the highlight of the day. I wanted to watch this game, but I was having problems, you know, with my feed, you know, on my ESPN app, which I pay for. And then they weren't showing the game. And then I had to watch that freaking Portugal and Ukraine game that did not give me a single goal. You know, I was falling asleep midway through the game. You know, I really wanted to watch this game. One of my, you know, countrymen from St. Vincent was actually at this game. He was posted on Instagram. And I told him that, you know, he's there to watch Czech Republic spank England. I was only joking, though. I was definitely joking, you know. England coming out the superior team. So, guys, let's do a quick recap of how the group standings look so far. How the group standings look right now. In Group A, we had Group A fixtures today. England on top with 3 points. Then we have Montenegro second, 1 point. Bulgaria third, 1 point. Kosovo yet to play. And Czech Republic at the bottom. Two teams I'm predicting to come in through, to come through from this group. England and Kosovo. That's my surprise pick. Kosovo, they have been playing really, really well, picking up a 2-2 draw versus Denmark in their last international friendly. So go Kosovo. I know a lot of Serbians wouldn't like me, you know, for this, but it's all football, nothing political. Group B, Luxembourg on top the group, 3 points. Portugal second, 1 point. Ukraine third, 1 point. Serbia yet to play. And Lithuania at the bottom without a point. Portugal, Serbia, two teams I'm picking to come through from this. You know, Ukraine definitely in the mix. Luxembourg, could we see them making, you know, their debut? This should be their debut at a competitive tournament. Then in Group C, yesterday we had Netherlands topping that group right now. 3 points. Northern Ireland, second, 3 points. Germany yet to play. Estonia, 0 points. And Belarus at the bottom without a point. Then in Group D, guys, we haven't had a game from Group D as yet. I think Group D plays tomorrow, where we have Denmark, Georgia, Gibraltar, Republic of Ireland, and Switzerland. Group E, Slovakia topping that group so far. Croatia second, Wales third yet to play. Azerbaijan without a point, and Hungary without a point. Group F, yet to play. Faroe Islands, Malta, Norway, Romania, Spain, and Sweden. Spain, Sweden, front runners to top this group. Romania, you know, looking good. Norway looking good, topping their UEFA Nations League group as well. Group G, Macedonia topping that group so far. Poland second with that win yesterday over Austria. Slovenia third, Israel fourth, Austria fifth, Latvia at the bottom. Group H, France topping that group with that big win today. Iceland second, Turkey third, Albania fourth, Andorra fifth, and Moldova sixth. Guys, remember Iceland and Turkey, they were in the same qualifying group for the World Cup, I think. So, familiar foes. They will be fighting for one of these Euro 2020 spots. And the last group, well, no, they have two more groups. There's so many groups. There's 10 groups, guys. In Group I, Cyprus topping that group. Could Cyprus be a surprise qualifying team for Euro 2020? I think Sami Khiani said that Cyprus could qualify for that tournament, in his opinion. Kazakhstan with a big upset, second. Belgium third, 3 points. Russia fourth, Scotland, and San Marino at the bottom. And last but not least, Group J, with Armenia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Finland, Greece, Italy, and Liechtenstein yet to play a game. So guys, we are just about the 20-minute mark, and that's all I have for today. Just wanted to do a quick recap of, you know, today's fixtures. Touch base with you guys. Let me know if I missed any big talking points in the comment section down below. Let me know which games you saw. If you're new around here, consider hitting the subscribe button. Smash the thumbs up button. And until tomorrow, peace out. Rich Squad!